So I watched the first episode of the new MCU show What If with my girlfriend, and it was at best a bearable time waster. The visual style may not be everybody's cup of tea, but the animation itself is quite good. And the fact that I have to wave my hand and say the visuals are nice before mentioning anything about the story should already tell you what I thought about the episode as a whole, but we'll get to it. So we talk about the show afterwards, as you do, and we quickly end up with the same bottom line. I mean, she said it first, but I wholeheartedly agree, and what she said was, I just didn't feel anything. And there's plentiful reasons for the lacking emotional resonance. The entire episode is just a rushed retread of the first Captain America movie, the writing itself is flat, and any understanding of the characters, their motivations, and relationships is banking on the fact that the viewer has already seen the aforementioned movie. It's nostalgia baiting, it's lazy, and even with the borrowed material and a mere 30-minute runtime, the episode still manages to create several plot holes and inconsistencies. My favorite is the fact that Carter becoming Cap in place of Steve is supposed to be the definitive difference in the episode's universe and the rest of the multiverse, the nexus point from which the timeline splits. And yet, this difference apparently also somehow increases Howard Stark's mental capacity thousandfold, allowing him to suddenly pull out a fully functioning Iron Man armor out of his ass in the 40s. The show is pure spectacle, zero brain work. Fuck the stakes, fuck consistency, look at the pretty colors. But aside from that, there's also something deeper. Something fundamentally wrong about the show on a conceptual level. Funny thing is, the show What If has the exact opposite problem to Marvel's previous show Loki. Both are high concept shows of cosmic proportions, wherein the emotional investment of the viewer is utterly assassinated, provided they give the story and its metaphysics even a second of actual thought. So let's poke at Loki real quick before circling back to What If. Without going into the details too much, the big devastating world-building element Loki introduces to the MCU is the fact that there has always been a single predetermined path for the entire cast, planned out by a quirky space god dude named Kang. And not just that, everything in history has gone along his grand design. So the Holocaust happened because Kang wanted it, and the 9/11 happened because Kang wanted it, and the live-action Mulan happened because Kang wanted it, thanks for that one. It's dumb and retarded, and let's leave it as it is before I rupture a vessel. This revelation retroactively makes it so that every story in the MCU prior to Loki is utterly meaningless. Everything we saw was decided beforehand. Not a single hero has decided to be a hero. Not a single villain has decided to be a villain. No one has truly saved anyone, no one has redeemed themselves, no one has sacrificed themselves for the greater good. Turns out, it was Kang all along. Think about it. Tony Stark, the hedonist, playboy billionaire arms dealer. His journey, all his growth, his mistakes, his losses, his victories, his relationships, culminating in him saving the entire universe and paying for it with his own life. All of that is meaningless now. He decided none of it. If he had tried to do anything different from the choices we saw, he would have been teleported to the end of time by Kang and fed to a purple fart cloud dragon thingy. Yes, Loki is a dumb show. If one is to accept Loki into the MCU canon, then it also means discrediting every single hero that came before. Every event, every movie, all down the drain. None of it mattered. Predeterminism is always horrid in storytelling. Do not do it! Now switching back to What If, as I said before, the show fundamentally suffers from the exact opposite problem, that being the existence of infinite alternative realities. On paper, the appeal is clear. If there are infinite universes, then anything is possible. Creators can mix and match characters and events as they please, and it can be all excused, at least in theory, by pointing at the fact that there are indeed infinite realities. But therein lies the problem. If a story takes place on a timeline with infinite replicas, where all are slightly different, where anything is possible, then by all logic that also means that everything has also happened. That's what infinite literally means. Example. You follow a character through their arc, see their highs and lows, learn to know them in and out, the character becomes almost like a real person. And then, through a tragic turn of events, the character meets their demise. Let's say it's the best death scene ever. They get to be a badass for one last time, say some cool lines, save a lot of people, make you remember for one last time why you liked them so damn much in the first place. And then they are gone. You feel sad? You feel like you've lost something. Why is that? Well, that there is called stakes. Now, how do you get stakes? By creating something unique. Something that is one of a kind. A person who is so specific that they become tangible. That's when stories become meaningful. When they mirror real life. You want to see the people you care about succeed. And you fear for their safety. Because if you were ever to lose them, then you would lose something that you can never get back. And that is a scary thought. But if you have infinite realities, none of that exists. If anything bad happened to a character in a story such as What If, then so what? There must be an identical universe adjacent to it where the only difference is that the character did awesome. Why not just follow that universe instead? And then everybody gets a fairy tale happy ending. It's a sleight of hand and emotional manipulation from the writers.
No, man, don't think about it. Just look at all the cool characters you like going boom, boom, pow, pow, yeah.
It's pure spectacle and no substance. That's what modern mainstream entertainment is all about. And here's the problem with infinite possibilities and the concept of what if in a nutshell. No matter what happens, I won't be able to care. Because the characters are no longer characters. They and their supposed struggles are basically failed save states in a video game. I'm not emotionally moved by game over screens. Are you? Well, that's all I got for now. Thanks for lending an ear. Hopefully this is the universe where all of you subscribe for more. Hint, hint. Take care, everyone, and I'll see you all in the next one.